Hello everyone, in this video we are going to cover the same lesson which we have seen in the previous videos. More on SQL is going to continue. Here last videos, in our previous video we have seen that in under selection statement we have seen more classes, right? So in our future videos we are going to explore the classes one by one. So in this video I have covered about where class. Let's see what is that. So first we will see the introduction of SQL classes. So in under SQL classes, we have different types of classes. The first one is a where class. The second one is a order by class, having class, top class, and group by class. So in this classification, now we are going to see about this where class. Okay, so let's see what is that. So where class. What is where class? Why are we using where class? So where class is used to filter records. So we know that a database is made up of tables. So if it is a table, is a collection of records, right? In table you can able to see lot of records, a lot of attributes. So the combination of records and attributes is called as a table, and a collection of tables is called as a database. So in database and in SQL we are dealing with the table and queries, right? So queries to some information from the table, right? So in that, this where class is used to filter the records, and it is used to extract only those records that fulfill a specified condition. Okay, so if it is a record, there we will have some conditions, right? Whenever we are writing the query, we will be writing the condition. Along with the condition only, we will write the queries, right? So whatever records fulfill that specified condition, the user will specify some conditions, right? If the condition is fulfilled, it will extract what are the records fulfilled that particular condition. If it is satisfied, then it will take the record. If the condition is not satisfied, then it will not. So the main aim to use a where class is used to filter the records. So these are the main points of where class. Let's see about the syntax of where class. Okay, so the syntax of where class is select column 1, column 2. Column 1, column 2, in the sense you have to write your column header. For example, if it is a student table, you can write select student ID and student name. Likewise, so select column 1 and column 2 from table name. Table name you have to mention. Whichever table you are dealing with, that table name you have to mention here. Where condition. Okay, so at last only you have to apply the condition. Understood? So this is the syntax of where class. Now here is a note. Students, please make a note. The where class is not only used in select statement, it is also used in update, delete statement, etc. Only for select statement no need to use. Okay, this where class is not only used in the select statement, you can also use in the variety of statements we have, no, like a delete, update, insert, likewise. So you can use there also. Okay, update and delete statement also you can be able to use where condition. Okay, so if you want to specify any specific condition for the query, then you can use this where condition. Okay, to filter the records. So here is a database for your understanding purpose. I have given a database. The table name is customers. So the table name is customers, and the table shows the customer ID, customer name, age, and country. So let's see what is the first query on this. So here is an example for a where statement. Select star from. We know that already I told you that if it is a star, it will take all the attributes. Okay, all the attributes for that row, for that record, it will take all the attributes. Select star from customers. So from the customers table, whatever attributes present, it will take all the attributes. So select star from customers, where country is equal to Australia. So if you have seen the previous example database, here just look at the country, customers from various countries are there, right? But there, what is the condition? We have select star from customers. So from the customer table, we are going to take all the records where country equal to Australia. So which customer country is Australia, that about that customer we will take the record, that particular student information will be taken out. Okay, likewise, so the output of this will be like this: customer ID, customer name, age, country, all the attributes which are present in the table, that plus that that customer who is living in Australia, that alone will be displayed. Okay, so this is the way it will take the query. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. Now we are going to compare the text field and numeric field. So what is the difference and what is the similarity, that we are going to see now. So in SQL, it requires a single quotes around the text values, right? So if you watch that previously, then you may get that. Just look at here, Australia is written inside the single quote. Am I right? So if it is a text, it will be written inside the single quote or else a double quote. Okay, but you have to. So whatever text you are going to use in the queries, it should be written inside the single quotes or double quotes. And if it is a numeric field, it should not be enclosed in the quotes. If it is a text value, you have to use a double quote or a single quote. Anything you can use. If it is a numeric field, that is numbers, if it is a numbers, you should not enclose in quotes. Okay, don't use any quotes for writing, for just mentioning the numeric field. Okay, for text field alone, you have to use, whether you can use a single quote or else you can use a double quote, there is no issues. But if it is a numeric field, you should not use any quotes. Okay, it may be a single quote or a double quote, you should not use. So let's move on to the next one. Example for that numeric field, just look at here, select star from customers where customer ID is equal to 001. 001 is not written inside the quotes, single quote or double quote, right? So likewise you have to write, and the output of this will be the customer who has the ID 001, that alone will be displayed, but all the attributes will be taken from the database because of this star put. Okay, so this is the way I have to do. And now these are all the operators which are present in the where class. These are all the operations we can able to perform using the condition where, using the class where. Okay, so the first operator is equal operator, and the second one is a greater than, less than, greater than or equal, less than or equal, then this is not equal. Okay, so in some version of SQL, this operator may be written as like this. This also correct and this also correct. Okay, any one way you have to follow. And between a certain range, okay, between this to this, likewise, if there is a query, then you can use that. Then like in the sense, search of pattern. If it is a similar pattern, it will search and give you. Then in to specify multiple possible values for a column. Okay, you can able to type more than one. Okay, more than one data you can able to type in that. So that is the use of in operator. So let's see the next one. And operator. Okay, one by one we are going to see now. And operator or operator like that. So the and operator displays a record if all the conditions separated by and are true. Whether all the conditions, whatever condition mentioned in the query, if it is separated by and, then it will be considered as true. Okay, So this is a condition. Now we are going to see the syntax of AND operator using the select statement. So here is a syntax: select column 1, column 2 from table name, where condition AND condition. Condition 1 and condition 2 and condition 3. So always you have to enclose your condition statement at the end of the query. Okay. So let's see this example for this. See, this is an example for AND operator. Okay, this is an example for AND operator, and this is the syntax of AND operator. Now the example is: select star from customers where country equal to Germany and city equal to Berlin. Okay, so this is the query for the given AND operator. Okay, so select star from customer. From the customer table, it will select all the attributes. Okay, where country equal to Germany. In that, whatever you are going to choose, in that particular student should live in Germany, and the city has to be Berlin. Okay, there is no one know. So like this, you have to write the query for this AND operator. So the next one is OR operator. Okay, so the next one is OR operator. The OR operator displays a record if any of the conditions separated by OR is true. In that AND operator, both has to be satisfied, then only it will give the true value. But in this operator, OR operator, it will display a record if any of the conditions separated by OR is true. Any one condition, if it is true, then this operator will display that record. Okay, any one condition. Okay, so let's see the syntax of this. So here is a syntax for OR operator: select column 1, column 2 from table name, where condition 1 or condition 2 or condition 3. Okay, so now you may get to know how to write the syntax, right? How to write the queries, right? All the operators and all the statements will have a same structure of the query. So it will be very easy when you started practicing more. Okay, so practice more and try to write more queries, then it will be very easy to write in the practicals. Okay, so let's move on to the next one, example. Okay, example for OR operator is: select star from customers where city equal to Berlin or city equal to Mumbai. Any one condition, whether the city is Berlin, then also it will take that record. Whether the city is Mumbai, then also it will take a record. If any one condition alone true, another one is false also, it will take that record. Okay, so likewise you have to do. Okay, so let's move on to the next one: combining AND, OR and NOT. So each one separately we have seen. If you combine everything, then how it will be, that we are going to see now. So the following SQL statement: select all fields from customers where country is Germany and city must be Berlin or Mumbai. So we have used a query which is used to select all the field from the customer table, okay, where the country is Germany and the city must be Berlin or Mumbai. Berlin or Mumbai, any one is true means it will take that record. Same time, it should satisfy country. The country should be Germany, then only it will take that record. Okay, so likewise it will be executed. So here is an example. So select star from customers where country is equal to Germany and city equal to Berlin or city equal to Mumbai. So that OR statement is written inside the parenthesis, right, to form the complex expression, like a nested queries. Okay, so a query inside another query. Likewise, you can write. So this is the example for combining AND, OR and NOT. So I hope you all understand about the WHERE class and why are we using WHERE class, what is the need of the Wearclass and how to write the queries in Wearclass and what are all the possibilities are there, that everything we have seen today. I hope you all understand the concept clearly. If you have any doubts, please kindly watch the videos again and again, then you may get the clear knowledge on this. So thanks for watching. Thank you.